In a quiet street in the Marais in Paris lurks this little place. Ostensibly an Azzedine Alaïa shoe store, but really an extraterrestrial fantasy. Formed from leather, brass and marble.
Well, I never really intend anything to look kind of like a spaceship or a space capsule or for it to necessarily have sort of sci-fi overtones, but things somehow just end up like that. I approach these projects with an almost kind of mundane pragmatism. This is there, that's there, this is fixed, that can't be changed. I've got to work around this column. The whole process for me is a little bit like joining the dots. You may ask, you know, where's the kind of creativity in there? And I guess for me, it's between the dots.
Working with marble has inspired him to push this ancient material into even more contemporary shapes. But he doesn't work with any old marble. Mark uses Carrara marble, quarried here in the Alps of northern Italy. The wonders of Rome were hewn from this stuff. Bernini's Apollo and Daphne is made from it too. And of course, Michelangelo himself sculpted in Carrara marble when he created David. Back to the future. And Mark Newson's decided all his pieces should be made from a single block too, which is...
It's very difficult. It's not good. Dark vein, too small, like a cheese. No. It's too dark. Strong veining. Forget it.
Once they have found the right piece, the craftsmanship kicks in. The chaps in the workshop are absolutely forbidden from making any joins or sticking anything on. Here in the quarry yard, diamond-coated wire is cutting through the block to create a very special table, with the innards going straight on the tip. These pieces are as much about what isn't there as what is. Inside, an extruded table is being polished up. What was a 30-ton block is now a half-ton table.
To think this piece comes from a single block of marble is just indescribable. It's magnificent. It's thin and light, not heavy in shape. This table is fantastic.
And this lathe table is nearly finished. Ugo here fancies one for his dining room.
I like this table from the moment I saw it. I'd love to have it at home. But taking into account one's financial circumstances, I really don't know the price.
Over at Newson's storage space, we've met up for a rather rudimentary unveiling.
Bloody hell.
This piece I'm sitting on feels like it's it looks like plastic, this material, and it looks like it could have been easily mass-produced.
Yeah. Marble in this particular case, I mean, you've got to know that these pieces are made in marble. I mean, if these pieces were made in many, many other different materials, they wouldn't be as impressive, I think, as they are. But these pieces are very, very much about the material. And when you know, seeing them from a distance, and it may not be obvious that they're marble, is completely different than looking up close and going, how the hell did he make that? Or how did they produce that thing?
This work is design work by a designer. It's in a gallery, and it's there because you can experiment and stretch yourself in ways that you couldn't if you were working for a client.
Precisely. You know, these are my technical experiments. You know, these are exercises that I set myself. You know, every time I embark on working with a new material or with a new process, for me it's like, you know, it's like doing a, a new course at university. You know, it's a learning process. The whole reason I do this stuff is not to, you know, I don't acquire this stuff. I'm not a collector. You know, I don't own any, I own precious little of my own work, and I have no real interest in owning any of my own work or anyone else's for that matter. But what I get out of it at the end of the day is the knowledge that I've accumulated during the process of producing that thing, which is to say that the knowledge that I've gained making these pieces, I can then apply it to a more industrial product. And at some point, at some time, it will, that knowledge will be invaluable.
These pieces were shown at the Gagosian Gallery in New York last year. His latest show opened today at their space in London.
Gagosian, or GoGo as it's called, is the world's most powerful contemporary art gallery. And so when Larry Gagosian invited Mark to stage an exhibition there, it was a huge move, not just for Mark, but for design.
So now he's exhibited by the same gallery as Damien Hirst. But for his New York show, Newsom was determined to make and display something absolutely functional too. And here it comes, wrapped up in an old bedspread. A groundbreaking surfboard that seen and survived active service on the world's scariest waves. This is Garrett McNamara. A man with no fear, dicing with death on Mark's revolutionary board. As a tow-in surfer, he faces massive waves far out to sea. This super-heavy board's made from an alloy of nickel and cobalt, the same stuff they use to make helicopter rotor blades. When the going gets tough, it could save his life.
The guy's a complete and utter madman. I mean, no one in their right mind would do the kinds of things that he does. He's utterly, utterly insane.
So this is Garrett's surfboard, and no one else in the world has got a surfboard like it.
Absolutely. I mean, it was an idea we hatched that I had, and I proposed it to Garrett. I mean, it was almost like a dare.
Do you realise it was also going to look very beautiful?
I had an idea that it would look fantastic. Absolutely. But this is ultimately a completely functional object. It looks great because of what it does, and because of the way that it answers particular problems and deals with sort of particular issues. I mean, this is more like designing something for an aeroplane, for a piece of aviation. I mean, you know, this really, really has to perform in extreme conditions.
Extreme conditions are getting more and more appealing to Mark Newsom these days. And he's setting his sights rather higher than just sea level. In 2004, he made this, Kelvin 40, the concept jet of his dreams, named after the central character in Andrei Tarkovsky's science fiction film, Solaris. Kelvin was commissioned by the Cartier Foundation and displayed as art in their prestigious gallery. It was all about Mark's fantasy of what aviation could be, but now he's focusing on the reality of mass transit. So today, he's come to see this, the Qantas A380, the biggest passenger jet in the world. He's designing the interior, but the exterior takes his breath away.
I think it's absolutely stunningly beautiful.
Oh, wow.
It's kind of mind-boggling. You're absolutely dwarfed. It's pure engineering. And when engineering is that good, and when engineering is that sort of refined, it's often very, very beautiful. I've always loved aeroplanes. You know, the objects themselves and the idea of flying, I love. The problem is, of course, you know, the reality. You know, when was the last time you enjoyed getting on an aeroplane? I mean, no one loves flying anymore. No one even likes flying.
Mark wants to change all that.